now request chartered accountant and advocate, young blood of India, of Tamil Nadu, founder of Vivekananda Institute of Leadership and Governance, Sathya Kumar, to come over and share his thoughts about what it means to be a, what it means for the youth to be a prolific problem solver, especially using a technique called the design thinking. Sathya Kumar. He is an advisor to the Ministry of Finance, is a visiting faculty teaching design thinking in IIM Ranchi. Sathya. Yeah,
thank you. It's a great pleasure to be here in this afternoon addressing the most enlightened audience. In fact, whatever I'm supposed to speak, I was just sharing to one of the Swamiji here that most of them have covered from morning. But let me tell you, everybody talks about the same quote, and to pass on the message, everybody is inspired to do the work from the same quote in a different path. And in my journey, when I took up my chartered accountancy, I was actually not performing well in the school. And when I took up the chartered accountancy, I wanted an ideal. And in my school, they used to conduct a program called Man-Making Education every Saturday. I used to sit in the last bench, make fun of that course, my secretary, Mr. Narayan Rao-ji, and post my school education, when I came for chartered accountancy, I told my father, whether will I be able to qualify this course, which is such a hard course, whether I'll be able to qualify. He said, nothing, get on, go by 21G, get out at Mylapore, go and get Swamiji photograph. And Swamiji said the message, be bold. And that message gave me the confidence. And then I qualified my chartered accountancy course, company secretary, law degree, and I became a chartered member of the UK also. And I was working in KPMG. I left my job to actually pursue what is the vision of Swamiji. Swami Vivekananda said, we have to create the new India. And to create a new India, we have to know the problem of India. Today, the problem of the youth is that they are getting educated from the best of the institution, like IITs, IIM, and best of the institution, but they don't know the ground reality of this nation. So to ensure that I know the ground reality of this nation, I traveled across India. Now, I not only traveled across India, wherever I went, I started lecturing so that I get connected to the people. I've traveled to a place like Tinsukia in Assam. I've traveled to a place like Kohima. I've traveled to a place like Sangli. I've traveled to Nagarkoil, Tiruchengodu, Sangagiri, Karur. You name any second tier city, I've traveled there to know the potential of the this country. At that time, when I was traveling, I was also attending to a course called Design Thinking, which is developed by Stanford University. Let me tell you, today Stanford University talks about design thinking. One of the best design thinker of this world is Swami Vivekananda. The reason is, Swamiji not only read the books and texts and knew the Vedanta, but also know the practical Vedanta, how to make it more relevant to the youth and the people of the country. And when we read these texts, then I decided that I should have a social enterprise. So what is this design thinking all about? How did I come to the social enterprise called Vivekananda Institute of Leadership and Governance? Post my job, when I left the KPMG, and when I interacted with the people, then I came across a report which said, only 20% of the people who get into the school get into the higher education. Balance 80% of the people are dropped out from the school. This is a serious problem. Because the people who actually get graduated, maybe they are lacking nationalism. Most of them feel that 20% of the people who get graduated from the best of the institutions or getting graduated feel India is a jail. They wanted to get out of this India at any cost. Go to US and don't come back to India. This is the mindset they have, majority of the people. That 80% of the people are frustrated about the country because they are not educated. They are only trying to make their livelihood. Now, we try to analyze what is the problem of the people. Then we found lack of intelligence, lack of knowledge about the schemes brought by the government is a problem. It came because we are empathetic about the people. Empathy, the quotient of empathy. In fact, in MMA, we have done a lot of programs for training the common man and the business people across the state of Tamil Nadu, where we have gone and preached about how do we empower the entrepreneurs. It all started with the empathy. And this design thinking model is, it may be an organized model from the West, but Swami Vivekananda already did this. Let me tell you, this design thinking has five-step process. First step is being developing empathy. There is a difference between sympathy and empathy. Sympathy is nothing but when somebody comes out with a problem and talks about a problem to you, you just hear it and leave it and say it is other person's problem. Empathy is that you hear that person's problem and think what we can do over that problem. That puts you to the quest, and that quest will go and make you to define the problem. Moment you define the problem, then you will ideate what to do on the problem and prototype on that problem, try to do small, give solutions through prototype model, and then finally you test that, and if it is successful, you will take it to the larger people. Look at, for example, today Ramakrishna Mission and MUT has about 200 plus centers in India, and it has almost has about 1,800 plus people who are sacrificing their life, monk, who are sacrificing their life for building this nation. And you look at the model of Ramakrishna Mission, it is into education, upliftment of poor people, it is into healthcare, it is into developing medical assistance. So this is exactly the model which has to be embraced by the youth of India today. Swami Vivekananda is not only a spiritual giant from India, he is a great social entrepreneur. Swami Vivekananda is not just a spiritual giant from India, he is a great thinker of Asia. Swami Vivekananda is just not a spiritual scientist, he is also a social scientist. Swami Vivekananda is everything. If you ask me what is India, I will say Swami Vivekananda is India. Because you read Swami Vivekananda, you will understand India. It is just not me. There are many people who got inspired out of Swami Vivekananda. Mahatma Gandhi got inspiration from Swami Vivekananda. Nelson Mandela got inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi. So Swami Vivekananda not only got freedom for India, Swami Vivekananda got freedom for Africa also. That is the kind of impact Swami Vivekananda made. And Subhash Chandra Bose got inspired from Swami Vivekananda. Why? Well, not only Indians, even global leaders got inspired from Swami Vivekananda. Look at, for example, Tesla. He got inspired from Swami Vivekananda. Rockefeller Foundation. Rockefeller got advices from Swami Vivekananda. We all know about Jamshedji Tata. Jamshedji Tata built IISc in Bangalore with a vision provided by Swami Vivekananda. And that is a kind of a impact Swami Vivekananda created in the life today. So this is the youth should actually embrace Swami Vivekananda. For this, what I did, I went and spoke to my school founder, Mr. Narayan Rao Ji, who gave us education to me and my brother. The school is in Tambaram. It's called Sita Devi Garuda Hindu Vidyalaya. Last year is no more. Last year in February, I went and interacted with him. And I asked, I want to do something for the nation. He said, you have a great knowledge with you. Why can't you translate this knowledge to the larger section of the people, which you are already doing? Let me give a small example. And he said, this is what your mission should be, enlightening the masses. He also said, educate the uneducated. Educate the uneducated. The role of the educated is to educate the uneducated. And I can understand when I went to IIM Ranchi for one of the programs they conducted on Radix. It's called Radix. When I went and asked that IIM graduates who was getting graduated from that institution, what you all wanted to become, believe me, 92% of the people raised their hands and said they want to become investment bankers. I asked, don't you have any other career other than this investment banking? And they said they're clueless what to do. Look at an institution of national importance, people are afraid to take up entrepreneurship. And go to Tirupur, you will find an 8th class person doing 2,000 crore turnover and exporting to America and Europe. And these educated people are most fearful people. And it came in Dainik Bhaskar. My article came in Dainik Bhaskar in the second day as an headline. Mr. Sathya Kumar came and said, what is entrepreneurship to IIM Ranchi? And then the director told Mr. Biswajit, the director, who is the director of IIM Ranchi, why can't you become a design thinking coach for IIM Ranchi? Let me tell you, we call that as a design thinking course, but whatever we say, it is all Swami Vivekananda's quote. And today, many people are transforming themselves into rural entrepreneurs. Many people are looking at how to empower the core citizens in the country. And this is exactly the thoughts that we see. It is not a problem with the youth today. The problem lies with the educated. The educated become more selfish in this nation. And when educated become more selfish, then the youths are not having the direction. It is the role of the educated to educate the uneducated. And when I told this, the people started doing this, and today we have a leadership and governance forum in IIM Ranchi. It is in a different name, but the idea came from Vivekananda Institute of Leadership and Governance, which we have ideated. What is the quote that is relevant? How I got inspired is, there is a quote by Swami Vivekananda which said, a nation is advanced in proportion to education and intelligence spread among the masses. This is exactly the empathy I got. 1947, we got independence, not to just construct roads and bridges. That the Britishers would have done. Britishers constructed St. George, Britishers constructed Ripon Building. They would have done better. We got independence because we want to explore the divinity of every citizen in this nation. But what happened? We did not change the education system in the country. Post-1947, whatever Lord Macaulay got, we prayed, we took that book, kept before Saraswati, and prayed that and wrote the examination. And we never changed the education system. And we are trying to change it, and system has become so bureaucratic that changing is very difficult. What we can do? We can reach out to the masses through digital media. So, as per the guidance given by my mentor, Mr. Narayan Rao Ji, I went and met Mr. Nalurottam Balu. Nalurottam Balu is one entrepreneur in social entrepreneur, and Nalurottam is not a registered entity. It is a movement of the people, which was spawned by one of the selfless individual called Shivram, who is friend of Narayan Rao Ji. Then he was doing in a small scale in Chennai. I became a strategist for that project. And today, that project involves student activity, student power. That project involves the village empowerment. That project involves the people's power empowerment. In this project, the one of the most favorite project for me, which I have been, is Manika Manavar. It says, it is called Ruby Students. What is this project? It's a simple project. We go on a single day to a school, government school, give them 100 questions to the student. 100 questions to the student. The condition is the student should score more than 80 marks. Student should score more than 80 marks. We get the list of the students. I will tell you why 80 marks at the end. So we will get the list of the students. We give them 100 questions, ask questions and debate, and we award them with something called Manika Manavar, that is Ruby student. You may ask me, by awarding them, how does it matter? For information, a single certificate to a government school kid inspires him for life. And it has four pillars. It has four pillars. One is about self-development, next is about family development, then street development and school development. That is the four pillars we have coined. And let me tell you, when I went to that project in October 2017, as per the guidance of my Narayan Rao Ji, it was actually only 100 students we were impacting. Today, across the state of Tamil Nadu, we have given more than 900 awards to the student. Now, what is the message? It is just not 900 awards. It is 900 skills we have identified in this state of Tamil Nadu as of now. 900 skills we have identified. What is a skill? In the Manika Manavar program, we conduct kind of a competition where the student exhibits his or her talent. Each talent is a strength of the kid. And that strength is a skill in India. And let me tell you one case study. We went to Kadalur. And we did this Manika Manavar program. And when we did this program, there was one girl who exhibited a great talent of yoga. And everybody was saying, yoga she exhibited, nah, that's all, nah. What I asked our parents, what is your vision? Every parent's vision in India is to make their kid engineer. That is a great obsession of India. And she was best in yoga. And I said, she can become a yogapreneur. They didn't understand. I said, she can teach yoga in Kadalur. She can teach yoga in Paris. I said, see, look, our Prime Minister Modi has made yoga as an international concept. Tomorrow she can even travel to abroad and teach yoga. And do you want to make her to sit in IT company? Then they got enlightened. Now that kid is starting her journey of yogapreneurship. That is called entrepreneurship. That is yoga plus entrepreneurship. In Kadalur, slowly she is transforming the people there. My concern is just not that kid. That talent which is there in Kadalur is today spread to the people of Tamil Nadu, and definitely it will transform the people in Kadalur in the first phase and then later in the Tamil Nadu. Are we recognizing? One Swami Vivekananda inspired so many people around the world. Why can't we find out Vivekanandas in the place where we are? The entire journey of Vivekananda Institute of Leadership and Governance is to explore the possibility of every kid through strategy to Nalurottam team. It's a people's movement where we find out the skills around the state of Tamil Nadu in the first phase, and we are evolving this concept to the international school also. We recently conducted Global Leadership Summit in one of the international schools. Let me tell you, if I say that I'm doing this government project, government school project, they will not accept. But I have to give another name, different name to international school. You know better. I said Global Leadership Summit. It's the same methodology. When I said global leadership or global leader, they don't want to become Indian leader. And then finally, we give all the inputs of nationalism and all inputs of culture. One student got up in that international school and questioned, why should we know the culture? I said simply, nationalism is the culture of India. Culture is nothing but the nationalism. Expression of that is patriotism. And if you don't know the culture, you cannot claim that you are from India. And culture is, it's a matter of local concept. Please understand. Why should people understand the culture? To bring inclusiveness. That's very, very important. And that we are doing. Recently, we have also inaugurated through Vivekananda Institute of two using design thinking concept. That five-step process, we have inaugurated youth parliament also, where you all go to the various schools, you will find that model United Nations being conducted. You go to IIT, model United Nations will be conducted. We don't understand half of the time what is that. United Nations concept. Let me tell you, all these myths we are breaking, we are bringing Indian models on all this debate concept that youth parliament has become more successful. Can I tell you one secret? That video is also there. Sixth standard student, as if he's the MP, minister, is talking about GST. I can show you that video, such a proficient way. What more on chartered accountant will give him happiness, seeing a sixth standard student talking about GST. Right? So that is a kind of a level at which people are thinking today using this project. We are scaling it up. And it all started like this. A sculptor knows when he takes the marble to sculpt, he knows what is the result. Similarly, a painter knows when he paints what is the result. Nowadays, teachers don't know what is the result of the student, what they will become. I'm sure the teacher should take up the role of the man-making education. The role of the man-making education is the vision of Swami Vivekananda. And that empathy has to come to the teachers. We need more teachers than engineers in this nation. We need more medical assistants than doctors in this nation, because we have only one medical assistant for every 1,000 in India. And look at the doctor proposition, right? It's very alarming to note. I'll conclude by another, he has given 2 minutes, I was supposed to say 30 seconds. If you look at Indian government has come out with the New India campaign. Moment Honorable Prime Minister said New India, I was searching where is the definition of New India. And you know who is the best solution provider? Google Baba. I went to Google and I put New India. The first definition that came, first quote that came was Swami Vivekananda's. Then I wanted to really understand what is New India is all about. He says, Swami Vivekananda says, let New India arise out of the peasant's cottage, grasping the plow, out of the huts of the fisherman, the cobbler, the sweeper, let her spring from the grocer's shop, from besides the own of the fritter seller. Let her emanate from the factory, from marts, from markets. Let her emerge from groves and forests, from hills and mountains. Let me tell you, post-1947, our focus should have been all these people who has been defined by Swami Vivekananda in this quote. Unfortunately, our policies were focused towards crony capitalism. And we need economic policies, inclusive policies, to empower the last mile citizen to integrate the humanism in this nation. And I'm sure today there is a kind of a consciousness in the government. They are trying to bring participatory governance from the people, and they are trying to empower. Simple thing, I will give a case study and close the session. I was given an opportunity in 2015. The All India Radio invited me for the first time. With all excitement, I called my friends and said, All India Radio has invited. And they said, nobody hears All India Radio nowadays. And I said, nobody hears, at least I will hear what I speak, I will go. Then they called me to do a program on Mudra Bank, Mudra Scheme, basically, when it was launched. When I went with a full heart, and the recording went in, and then it was telecasted. Exactly after 2 years, I went to Nagarkoil. I did a public session for about 550 people there on government policies. One lady was sitting in the first bench, and her name is Mala. She stood up and said, Sathya Kumar sir, I came to meet you in this program. It was organized by the government authorities, And she said, we saw the posters, your name was there, I came here to meet you. And she asked, why, how did you know me? She said, today I have got loan because of that campaign of Mudra scheme, what you did in the All India Radio. I asked, what is your life all about? She said, Mala was a day wage laborer. Mala was a day wage laborer in Nagarkoil. She was not having even a, she was in a thatched roof home, hut basically. And she was hearing this program in All India Radio. You know typically how people, after coming from labor job, they come, cook outside the hut, hear radio, which is old. She doesn't have a mobile, nothing. And she heard the radio. In that radio, I spoke about Mudra scheme in Tamil. It's a All India Radio, Tamil. And she heard that. She understood the scheme. All that she understood is bank will provide free loan without any security. That's all she understood. She walked into the bank. 14 times she walked into the bank. And bank denied, saying that there is nothing called Mudra scheme. One thing she remembered was, in that interview I said, if you don't get loan, please tweet to the Prime Minister. And she didn't know what is tweet. But she remembered tweet. And she told the bank manager, I will tweet to the Prime Minister. Immediately they gave the loan. And the story does not end here. The story does not end here. She got 79,800 rupees as a loan under Mudra scheme without any security and collateral. That is the scheme all about. Today, 13 crore people have got benefited under Mudra scheme, about 6 lakh crores. Even our Prime Minister Modi, Narendra Modi, when he addressed our Chicago live telecast in Chicago, he has mentioned in our program also how he is empowering the last mile citizen. She got 79,800. Using that, she started buying saris. Now Mala is called Surat Mala because she gets Surat saris. And the first customer was that bank manager. And today, Mala scaled up her business. Mala is living her life with a dignity, with identity. Dignity and identity. We may not understand the spirit of dignity and identity. You should ask the people who don't, searching for the identity in the society. I found that feeling of Mala, the identity and dignity. And Mala today scaled up her business, and you won't believe, on the same day in the lunch, I called the Honorable Minister for State for Finance, Mr. Pun Radhakrishnan, and I told, look, in your constituency, there is a person called Ms. Mala who has done this project. Why can't you think about making her as a brand ambassador for Mudra scheme? And he did it. Today, Mala is a management consultant. How? Very simple. Today, you and me go as a common man. Bank will say the same story. No scheme like that at all. If Mala goes, tweet to the Prime Minister is available. And she has got loan for so many people. And today she is transforming Nagarkoil's women. Woman is empowered. I would say woman-led development is happening because of her. And she is creating entrepreneurs in Nagarkoil. My dear friends, education in papers is useless until you have empathy. We need to have empathy. And everybody should become a design thinker, like Swami Vivekananda. And I can tell you, even Stanford University professor will accept, he's a great design thinker if he put across all his ideas. Our vision, whoever is attending here today, it is just not lecture here. Everybody should become a messenger of Swami Vivekananda. And I'm sure with the digital penetration happening, digital technology coming in, let all your nerves vibrate through that vitality of your religion. Religion is not separatism. I'm not talking about Hindu, Christian, Muslim. I'm talking about the culture of India. The culture of the real culture of India, the root of India. If you are embracing your culture, that means you are living ethically. If you are living ethically, that means you will explore the divinity. If you explore the divinity, empathy will come automatically. If empathy comes, your life is spiritual, because spirituality is not something to meditate. Spirituality is the well-being of others. And if you are able to do that, you can definitely transform India. Transformation of India is not just with the Prime Minister of India. It's just not with the Minister of Ministers in India. It is not just with the Chief Minister of any state. It is with every youth, who is about 800 million youth in this nation, who is going to be a transformational force, who is going to transform this nation. India is gifted today. The vision of glorified India of Swamiji is going to happen shortly, surely, because of the youth of this nation. You may say, youths are with full of problem. At least the youths are understanding they are in problem. That is the first step for development. Israel understood it is in problem. That is the reason Israel is number one in the innovation today. And same will happen in India shortly. Definitely, the aspiration of the youth, the impatient youth, will take this country forward. Definitely, the vision of New India will happen. By today, 2.5 trillion is the economy of India. By 2030, India will become $5 trillion economy. 2047, India will overtake China and it will be in the same level forever. And Bharat Varsha will be revived in 2047 and it will remain as the best country to contribute for GDP. GDP is just not important. Gross happiness index is more important than GDP. Gross happiness index. Many people talk about GDP. How does the gross happiness index will come? That is because of the character. The gross character index will contribute to gross happiness index. With this closing note, arise awake, stop not till the goal is reached. Our goal is to transform India. Let's have that goal with the self-development and family development. Three is social development. Self-development is important. Individual development is nation's development. Nation's development is individual development. With this closing note, let me close the session. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Sathya.